Hey guys, what's up? So Samsung has been making foldable phones for 2 years now, and it's interesting how even after costing so much, these phones don't get the best camera setup that Samsung has to offer. Take for example the Galaxy Z Fold 2, the latest foldable phone that Samsung has launched, and even after being launched after the S20 Ultra and the Note 20 Ultra, the phone still used a camera setup closer to what the S10 series was launched with. Now, when the Fold series first came out, it was fairly new and possibly there wasn't enough space for the 108MP camera sensor or a periscope lens to fit into the device, or we thought so. But since then, Huawei has launched the Mate X2, which has a 50MP main camera as well as a periscope camera with 10x optical zoom. So you would expect the Z Fold 3 to come out with a similar camera setup to the S21 Ultra, but guess what? Looks like they won't do it even now, as we have the camera details of the Z Fold 3, which reveals that the phone will use a triple camera setup at the back, and all of the three cameras will have a 12MP resolution. There's no information as to which sensors would Samsung use for these, but what we do know is that they will most probably use wide, ultra-wide and telephoto lenses on top of those sensors. Now, this would have been perfectly fine if Huawei had not launched the Mate X2 with a periscope zoom lens, but they did, and now it just feels like you're not getting the best possible value of your hard-earned money, especially since the phone would likely cost upwards of $2,000. Now, I do understand that foldable phones don't offer great value in the first place, but they should be able to justify the price tag in my opinion. Anyway, we also have the camera details of the other two camera sensors, and those would be the two front-facing cameras on the outer and inner display with a 10MP and a 16MP resolution respectively. Now, the 10MP sensor is the same that Samsung used on the Z Fold 2. In fact, the original Fold came with the same 10MP sensor on the front, while the inner 16MP sensor will be the IMX298 launched in 2015. To Samsung's credit, the inner camera would be placed under the display, but we are not sure of the outer one just yet. I guess we'll have to wait a bit to find out. Now, though Samsung isn't going all out on the current foldable phones, the company is surely experimenting with new foldable designs, and one such design that has been doing the rounds lately is a multi-folding device that can fold both inwards and outwards. Samsung seems to be working on a device with three screens and two hinges, dividing the main display into three sections. There's also a dual punch hole cutout for the selfie camera on the main display. Now, what's interesting is that the device even supports an S Pen, which can be attached magnetically to one side of the display when not in use for charging, or between the recess created by the two smaller displays on the back of the device for faster charging. When both the portions of the display are folded outwards, the device turns into a phone with a full screen display on the front and two smaller ones at the rear. When it is fully opened, the device turns into a large screen tablet, which also gives access to the dual cameras at the back, including an LED flash. Moving on, so Samsung has an unpacked event scheduled for the 28th of April, where they will be unveiling the most powerful Galaxy yet, and we now know what that most powerful Galaxy is. As you can see, it is none other than their Galaxy Book laptops. Samsung will launch three of these, the Galaxy Book Go, Galaxy Book Pro, and the Galaxy Book Pro 360. The Pro 360 is a convertible laptop with a 360-degree hinge, a touchscreen, and an S Pen support. The Pro laptops will come with Intel processors and start at $1,099 and go up to $1,299. The cheapest of the lot, the Galaxy Book Go, is an ARM Windows-based laptop powered by the Snapdragon 7C processor with 8 cores clocked up to 2.4 GHz. However, you only get 4GB of RAM and a 128GB of storage with the entry-level $350 variant. We will get more details on the 28th, so that's it for this video. Do tell me your opinions on the Z Fold 3's camera setup. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more tech videos and smash the like button if you liked it. I'll see you all in the next one. Till then, bye-bye and stay safe.